अब ये इधर उधर की चीजों में ज्यादा इंटरेस्टेड है।
आप चल लो तेज में से घुमा देते हो।
मेरा हार्ट बहुत टाइट पकड़ा था।
ये बिच्छू
बहुत, तुम्हारा भी बहुत टाइट पकड़ा हो। मेरा बहुत टाइट पकड़ा हो।
वेलकम टू होलीलॉग डे टू। We have come out today for a little walk in a park near where we live, and Aravir is loving it. He is loving it absolutely. Although he's taking really slow steps, so our walk has become a very slow stroll. But it's so much fun to be out with it. If you have a baby, go to the park.
Flowers, kitne acche.
Dekho flowers, flowers dekho.
Flowers, yeah.
Flowers, yeah.
Tree, yes. Oh my god, I have never seen rats out in the open like this. They have burrows over there. Oh dear god, it's so cute and so you at the same time. For breakfast I'm making green vermicelli. Basically I'm adding all green vegetables, so capsicum, we have spring onion, we have some broccoli, and we have some peas which I'm going to add. Usually I add carrots and beans as well, but I just thought let's change it up a little bit. My mother-in-law makes one with aloo and pyaaj. How do you make your vermicelli? So what do you add to your vermicelli? Comment that down below because I want to know. Besides the skip on the broccoli, didn't feel like eating that today. We are at 5027 right now. Yay! 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 I mean, yay! Yay! Dance, girl, dance. Dancey, dancey. Yeah!
Aravi, gandu bache. Aravi, gandu baby. Gandu baby. आप इसमें बोलो, आप बोलो, आप नहीं, मैं
नहीं बोलती। आई जस्ट टेकन अ बाथ एंड आई जस्ट वांटेड टू टेल यू गाइस दैट इफ यू आर लुकिंग फॉर अ ड्राई शैम्पू आई हाईली रेकमेंड दिस वन फ्रॉम बी ब्लंट. इट्स द बैक टू लाइफ ड्राई शैम्पू. इट इज द बेस्ट. ओके, so any other dry shampoo that I've used so far, they still leave my hair greasy and it's like, I mean, they don't do the work. This one really, really does the work. This one is really, really great. So if you were, I know, if you were looking for a dry shampoo, then I recommend this one.
So how I use it is, I simply first brush my hair to get all the tangles out. Then, so this is where my mom usually is. I don't spray it on this one ever. So I will spray the dry shampoo on a mom next to it and a mom next to it hair, not on this, because dry shampoos leave that nice nasty white kind of a look, although this one doesn't, but I don't really like to take chances, so I never spray dry shampoo on the main mang. What do you call mang in English? Parting. I don't usually spray dry shampoo on the main parting. And then just dab it in with hands. Same hair. And then repeat the process on this area of my head, and in the back just like two layers, so I don't put a lot so that it doesn't, I don't know if it damages the hair or not, but then I don't want to take a risk, so then I avoid using it like every single place. There's like three sections on this side, three sections on this side, and one section on the back of my head, and that's it. I think dry shampoo is such a great find for office going girls. When I was going to office, I would have, our college, when I was in college, I would have like loved to have this. I don't know if you can see if it makes a difference, but at least to me, my hair feels fresh. Because this is my hair on the second day of the wash, it won't, like, my hair would already be okay. My hair remains okay till like 2-3 days after wash. So even if I don't use a dry shampoo on the second day, my hair still looks like it's good enough. And I already woke up. Alright, he has slept again. Alright, he slept again. I am full of tips today. I'm going to give you another tip. If you've done your makeup a day before, then even if you take it off and everything, and if you have applied kajal, then you will notice the next day there's always a little bit of panda eyes going on. To remove that, what I like to do is, after taking a bath, I like to take an earbud, and I like to take Nivea cream. For the oddest reasons, this trick does not work with makeup removers, and any other cream irritates my eye. This is the only cream that works for this. So all I do is now simply remove any excess kajal that got left over. Can you see that? Can you see that? Yeah. That. Already. I know you guys must be thinking, Roli, are you going mad? Why are you putting makeup every single day? I don't know. I love makeup, and somewhere down the line, with, you know, being busy with so many things, I kind of lost that love of things, that love to do things for myself. So in this Holilog, I'm going to try and do makeup every day, try and look good every day, because not because of any other reason except that I want to look good for myself, and I want to do this for me. It's going to be a little gift for me. I, in the beginning of this year, I kind of thought that this year is going to be about me. I'm going to take care of myself better. I'm going to get my fashion sense back, because it's gone for a toss really badly. I'm going to get back in makeup, because I love it. I love it. As a little girl, I used to love playing with my mom's makeup. The reason why I picked up the camera right now was I wanted to talk about this lipstick that I got from Nykaa. It's their new matte lipsticks, and I really wanted to try it out. And I saw so many YouTube videos to figure out what shade would be best for me. And this is Caramel Mocha. The thing is, I love this shade because this is like exactly my lip shade. Exactly. It's like they took the color out of my lips and put it into a lipstick. But that is also the problem. Because then it's a little too nude. Like, I don't know. I mean, obviously it does look like I'm using lipstick, but I think I'm not used to wearing completely nude lipsticks, so that is why I don't know if I love it or if I don't love it. Like, that's the thing. Either I love it or I don't love it. Either I'm like, oh my god, this is so amazing, it matches my lip color exactly, or I'm like, it matches my lip color exactly, it doesn't even look like I'm wearing lipstick. So I don't know. What are your thoughts on nude lips? Do you have a nude lipstick? And if you do, then what are your thoughts on it? Do you love the way how it
blends perfectly with your skin and doesn't even look like you're wearing lipstick. Or you're like, जब लग ही नहीं रहा कि लिपस्टिक लगाई है तो फायदा क्या लेने का.
लंच नहीं खा लो कुछ. बाय बाय. शाम को चल रहे माइक्रोवेव फ्लेम में. ठीक है. मुझे मेरे एयरफोन्स भी रिटर्न करना था, साथ ही चलेंगे एयरफोन्स. नहीं नहीं उन्होंने मुझे गलत मॉडल दे दिया था.
Also, I just wanted to show you what I'm wearing because I love this. It's an anarkali from Biba. It is so summery. I know it's not completely summer right now. It's still spring, but who cares? So yeah. Hi, RGV. I love the ghera. I love it. अब मेरे फोन के साथ क्या कर रहे हो? बिट्टू, मम्मा का फोन है. आपने सबको गुड मॉर्निंग बोला? अब सुबह से सबसे मिलो? पता नहीं. गुड मॉर्निंग बोल दे सबको. हाय हाय हाय. बाय बाय. फॉर लंच वी आर हैविंग बूंदी का रायता, मूंग मसूर की दाल, मिक्स वेज एंड रोटी. RGV is having the exact same thing. I know you guys always ask me to do a video on what RGV eats in a day. He eats exactly what we eat. So this and this is exactly the same, except my dal is a little thinner, has a little bit of mirch. RGV's dal is a little thicker so that it's easier for him to eat, and it has a little less chili. And then again, the raita doesn't have hari mirch. This has hari mirch. Except that everything else is the same. खाना खाने नम नम.
फ्रॉग कैसे करते हैं? फ्रॉग कैसे करते हैं? फ्रॉग कैसे करते हैं? कैसे करते हैं फ्रॉग? कैसे करते हैं?
नहीं पेपर नहीं खाते.
फ्रॉग कैसे करते हैं?
खाते नहीं है.
फ्रॉग कैसे करते हैं?
अरे वीर फ्रॉग कैसे करते हैं? फ्रॉग कैसे करते
हैं?
कहाँ घुस रहे हो? न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ना है आपको.
Alright, I don't know where we got these nuts from. I just found these in our fridge. These are from the company called Go Nuts, and these are paneer tikka cashews. They are cashew flavored in paneer tikka, which sounds so interesting. The little label says, Go Nuts, a perfect taste of hand-picked nuts sourced from the world's best growing area. The company is based in India. It's based in Vashi, which is in New Bombay. Yeah, this sounds so interesting. I'm going to try one of these paneer tikka flavored cashews. Who would have thought of that? They don't really smell of anything specific. They smell a little spicy, but let's try. This is extremely weird because they do, and it, not in a bad way, but in a way that, so my mouth can taste paneer tikka, but it's confused because it's not paneer tikka. So my mouth and my brain is going like, what's happening, Roli? Are you eating paneer tikka or are you not eating paneer tikka? Because although the paneer tikka flavor is not like bang on paneer tikka, but it is there. It's kind of like, well, the taste that you get like initially when you take the first bite, it's like paneer tikka, and then it's like, that's a crunchy paneer tikka. I know, but it doesn't taste bad. It actually tastes really good, and it's a little bit, it's not a lot spicy. It's decent spicy enough. It's actually really something really, really good to munch on. I like it very much. I'm gonna try out any other flavors that they have. They have a website called gonuts.in, which I will check it out, because these actually look really nice.
I just saw we have more of these. So this was the paneer tikka one that I had. We also have it in salted roasted and lime and spicy. This sounds so nice. This sounds so nice. Lime and spicy.
Alright, I always wanted to do this kind of segment in my vlog since forever, and I've never actually gotten around to do this. The reason I want to tell the story of Holi and basically tell mythological stories is because I love mythological stories. I am an absolutely huge fan of mythological stories. I love listening to them, I like telling them, I like reading them, I like everything about them. So today I'm going to tell you the story of Holi. Why do we celebrate Holi? So there was this king called Hiranyakashyap who thought that I am the best king in the whole entire world. I am so good that people should worship me. That was his thoughts. And he actually went ahead and implemented those thoughts. So he pretty much ruled all over the earth, and he got, I don't think it would have been all over the earth, but basically it would have been all over the known earth to him. Because like, anyways, so he got all his subjects to worship him. He told everybody, you cannot worship other gods. There's no such thing as other gods. He banned all the mandals. He banned all the religious books. He banned everything. He was like, just worship me. Now, there's a tiny little problem. He had a little son called Prahlad. When Prahlad was little, he came across a murti of Lord Vishnu, of Lord Narayana, and he fell in love, and he asked around, and he was like, who is this person? Why is there this murti? What is the story? And people told him stories, which they weren't supposed to, but they did. And he got so intrigued by who this Lord is that he decided that he is going to pray to Lord Narayana. Now, of course, as a son, no son would look at his father as a god. All son would be like, huh, pray to my father, seriously? So that's what happened. He turned to another god, and his father got angry. And he got really angry. I'm pretty sure one of his crew must be loose, because Hiranyakashyap decided he's going to kill his son. The father decided he's going to kill his son because he just worshipped another god. Stupidest thing I've ever heard. But to be true, kings had a lot of wives and sons. So maybe in his head he was like, you know, if one of my sons dies, it doesn't matter, I have others. I don't know. I cannot find justification for why he would have thought that's okay to do, but he thought, I'm going to kill him off. After many failed attempts of killing Prahlad, Hiranyakashyap went to his sister called Holika. And Holika had this vardaan that she was not affected by fire. So even if she walked through fire, it would not affect her in any way. So the brother says to sister, listen, I want to kill off my son. And the sister says, fine, send him to me. You would imagine that the aunt would be like, no, send him to me. If you don't want to keep him, I'll keep him. No. The sister said, send him to me. I'll kill him for you. I cannot imagine how anybody can be so stupid. So the brother and sister decided that they're going to kill off Prahlad. So Hiranyakashyap sends his son and is like, "Ja beta, apne bua ke ghar jao, enjoy life." So Prahlad, like a little boy, he goes up to his aunt and he's like, "Hi aunt, how are you?" And she's like, "Hi beta, bilkul theek." And she says, "Let's go pray." So Prahlad is like, "Fine." So Holika takes Prahlad to a forest and makes him sit on top of a wood. What do you call those? Papraya? Like a lot of wood sticks together? What do you call that? A fire pit? I don't know. He basically makes him sit. So Holika sits on top of a lot of wood. I don't know what it's called. Wait. Called paya. I'm not sure how you pronounce it. But she basically sits on top of wood and tells Prahlad that, listen, I'm going to sit here. Why don't you sit on my lap, my little child? And he's like, okay. Fine. So they sit together and Holika says, let's pray to our god Hiranyakashyap. And Prahlad is like, yeah, fine, whatever. In his mind, of course, he's praying to his lord Narayana. Now, I don't remember the story clearly because I can't find this version anywhere online. But I somehow remember reading that Holika was like, let's pray to your god, lord Narayana. I'm not sure about that one. So anyways, they sit together and they're praying. And then Hiranyakashyap, although I doubt he did it himself, he probably hired somebody else to do it for him. Lights the wood that they're sitting on fire. And Holika in her mind thinks that I'm not going to get affected because I have a boon and the fire will not burn me. What she did not remember was that the boon was that Ashirwad basically was that the fire will not affect her if she is alone in the fire. So because Prahlad was with her, she started burning and she died. And because Prahlad was praying to Lord Narayana, Lord Narayana saved him and he got saved. So Holi is basically celebrated for the death of Holika. Now it's not just celebrated because like Holika was being a bad aunt and everything, but she was actually a really bad demon and she used to terrorize people around her. So that is why Holi is now celebrated. And on the eve of Holi, we light a little fire and we pray around it, and that's kind of how the story of Holi came to be.
Suna apne Holi kyun khelte hain?
So basically Holi is the celebration of good over evil. I'm gonna go ahead and make some pancakes for RGV. For that I've taken 3 teaspoons of whole wheat flour. I'm gonna add an egg. We'll next mix that all together, and if I need a little bit more consistency, I'm going to just eyeball the whole thing and add a little bit of milk and whole wheat flour again if I need some. So basically that's how I make the pancakes. Alright, so I added a little bit of milk and some little more atta to basically get this consistency. So with one egg you get roughly 2 pancakes, which is good for you and the baby. So 2 of you can eat it. And if your baby is hungry, he can even have 2 of them. So, but if you are hungry, you can have 2 of them.
My husband just came home and he got me this for 5k. Yay!
Kya hai isme?
Sab cake lag raha hai, but. Arey wah! Yay!
Thank you.
Yay!
Concentrate.
Yay! Thank you. ये तो बहुत ही अच्छा लग रहा है. वी हैव रिसेंटली डिस्कवर्ड दिस बेकरी कॉल्ड, इसे आपने पहले तो नहीं लिखते, कॉल्ड रारो. एंड वी बीन हैविंग केक्स फ्रॉम दिस, इट्स इन डिफेंस कॉलोनी मार्केट. वी जस्ट हैड केक्स फ्रॉम दिस अ कपल ऑफ टाइम्स एंड देयर केक्स आर एब्सोल्यूटली यमी. सो इफ यू आर इन दिल्ली एंड इफ यू लिव एनीवेयर नियर डिफेंस कॉलोनी, गो टू रारो. दे हैव अमेजिंग केक्स एंड दे हैव रियली नाइस फ्लेवर्स.
I have some old photos here. Not really old photos because they're RMV's photo and like they can be only as old as a year old. I got them printed off of photo prints by Zoom In, and I think I would like to highly recommend, if you're looking for mobile photos that you want to get printed, download the Zoom In app. It's super simple. You can just download it on your phone, you can pick photos from your phone, you can order it on your phone and you'll get it. It's like really really easy and simple. So I ordered some of RGV's photos and I was going to write down like tiny things on it. Basically on the back of it, I just want to remember. Obviously right now I remember what the photo is about and everything, but one day I'll forget. So for that, I just want to remember tiny little things like this is one of the photos. It has the cot mobile that RGV's dad got him. It has the giraffe, which was RGV's first favorite toy ever. So photos like this, I just want to write down on the back of it of what it depicts and what it has, so that I remember it, and then I will just put them in these albums, which again I got from Zoomin. So that is what I'm doing right now. As you can see, RGV is still awake, so I'm really not sure how much I'll be able to actually do, but let's try. This is one of me and RGV. Oh, this is RGV's first Valentine. How cute is this? His first Holi. I just posted this picture on Instagram as well a few days back. This is a photo of when he, I think when he first came back from the nursery. It's that day. So one of his first photos. Again, one of his first photos. These are the first pair of clothes that he ever wore, which I have kept. Oh. I didn't mean. No. And this is a cake from the day when RGV came to the house for the first time. One of our first family photos. We all look really ridiculous, but it's our first family photo. RGV used to cry like this. When he was really small, he would take his little lower lip out and then cry like this. Focus camera, focus. That is the first wrap that we ever had. This is an Anmol stretchy wrap, and I used to love this wrap a lot, but then now RGV is a little too grown up, and I think this kind of suits babies till around the 6 months old. So this was our first wrap. This was our first baby wearing experience. This was the first time RGV ever visited a coffee shop. Yeah. I have a picture of us when we first came back home. The first time RGV entered this house, and me and hubby both look absolutely ridiculous in this photo. I don't want to show it, but I'm going to show it because I look so bad. Especially because everybody told me to cover your ears and cover this and cover that. But whatever. I look really bad. I'm going to warn you, I look really bad. I look like a homeless. We look like such homeless people in this photo. It's like we've just come over to a house and we're like, beta, please, auntie, chanda de do. हमारा बच्चा है, चंदा दे दो, हम चंदा मांगने वाले लग रहे हैं. Well, to kind of make you forget how bad we look, this is the first photo of RGV attending his first wedding of his entire life. It was my sister Sakshi's wedding when we were going to, and yeah, that's the first wedding RGV ever attended in his entire life. I will get back to this after I help RGV sleep. Right, RGV has just slept. A very weird thing happened. I'm sure a lot of you have already seen that video where the mother sings and then the baby he just starts crying every time his mother sings. Exactly that happened with me right now. So I was kind of singing RGV to sleep, which I honestly don't do every night. Either I tell him a story or it's a nursery rhyme. Today, for some reason, I just decided to sing to him. And he made that sad face that I was showing you. He made this face, and he hasn't made this face since, like, he used to make this face when he was, I think, around two or three months old. And after that, he kind of just stopped making this face. And he made this face and he started crying. That is so unusual. I don't know. Anyways, let's get back to the pictures. That is the first chair RGV ever had. So that was his first swing chair, which was gifted to him by one of his masis, Nitika. If you're watching this, thank you so much. RGV loved this chair. Again, another one of the first Holi photos. So I used saffron and chandan for RGV. Actually, I'm gonna do a video tomorrow, I think. Most probably I'm doing a video tomorrow. So tomorrow's vlog will contain information about how you can play Holi with babies that are really young. So babies who are like 0 to 1 years old or 0 to 2 years old, how you can play Holi with them, how you can still be safe and play Holi with them. So I'll be doing that video tomorrow. This was the first play gym RGV ever had. This is the first time RGV visited my mom's place, his first visit to nanny house. I'm gonna hide one photo out of this because he's Nikki in that, but this collage pretty much sums up RGV's first week of his life. So yeah, now I think I'll just go and put these photos in these albums. I will see you guys again tomorrow. I'm going to end this vlog right here. If you haven't subscribed already, subscribe already. I hope you've had an amazing day. Tomorrow is another exciting day. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye!